हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सेशन ऑफ सब्जेक्ट DWPD। टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू अवर यूनिट नंबर 1, इंट्रोडक्शन टू HTML एंड CSS विथ टॉपिक नेम HTML5 टैग्स एंड HTML4 वर्सेस HTML5। नेक्स्ट ऑब्जेक्टिव, आफ्टर लर्निंग दिस वीडियो स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू नो अबाउट वेरियस टैग्स ऑफ HTML5 and difference between HTML 4.0 and HTML 5.0. Now start our session with HTML 5.0 tags. List of HTML 5 tags are header, navigation means NAV tag, section tag, article, aside and footer. Now this diagram show the location of various HTML 5.0 tag in web page. First one is header. After that, navigation section is come. Then left hand side section and article will come. And at right hand side, we can put a side tag. And at last, footer tag is there. Now first, header tag. A header tag allows user to define a section which define header of a web page. It is used to display banner, logo, title and subtitle of web page. We can use multiple headers within a single website. For example, header, after that our header of a tag, we can write VPMP Polytechnic in H1 tag, H2 tag or bold, then / header. Next tag is NAV, navigation tag. It allow user to define a section that contains set of navigation link. It is intended only for major block of navigation link. It is a section containing links to other documents or to parts within the current documents. Example, we can write various hyperlink between NAV and / NAV tag. Here I write first home, then login and then registration link. When user click on home, then the page is navigated to index.html. Same way, when the user click on login, then login page is open. Next is section. A section allows user to define various types of section in a web page. A web page could normally be split into sections for introduction, contact information and content of a web page. It can be a header, footer, chapter, etc. For example, section, then we can write a welcome to my website in H1 tag, then / section. Next is article. Article specify independent self-contained content. It allow user to define a section which is independent from the remaining layout of a web page. For example, article, then header, then in header we can write our heading part, then normal text, then in footer we can use same 5/5 CE department students, then / article. So in article we can use a header tag, footer tag, etc. Next is aside. Aside element defines some content aside from the content. It is placed in like a sidebar. This tag is used for navigation link, latest news, user login, etc. Can be placed inside aside tag. The content should be indirectly related to the surrounding the content. For example, aside latest news, then we can put market tag aside. Next is footer tag. A footer element allows user to define a section which define footer of a web page. It contains various information such as who developed it, copyright data, authorship information, contact information, back to top links, etc. For example, footer, then I write copyright 2016. So this statement must be placed in footer and slash footer tag. Now first I explained you this all tags with practical. Here I prepared one page which is similar to our Google page like this. This page is designed in HTML 5.0. It is similar to our Google front page. So for that, first open Notepad and write coding like this in header part. Here the user, here I put design Google page using HTML 5.0. So this content is in center tag and h1 tag and it is placed between header and slash header. After that we can see in a next navigation part two links are there and one button is there. So this navigation link is placed between nav and slash nav tag, navigation tag. After that some section part is there. So here I write section and slash and slash section and slash section, and between this one image is put. Then after that one text box is there, and after one text box two button is there, for one for Google search and one for I am feeling lucky. So this is a search bar and I put these three type in article tag, article and slash article. In article and slash article I write input type equal to text, then name equal to text, placeholder equal to search Google for type URL, and this text is display in this text box, search Google or type URL. Next, one submit button is there, two submit button is there, one for Google search and second for I am feeling lucky. After article tag, here I put one footer, copyright to Google account user. So here this text is put in a P paragraph tag, and this paragraph is I put in a footer and slash footer. So such way we can design a web page using HTML5, and our static Google page is like this. Now next is main difference between HTML 4.0 and HTML 5.0. Now HTML 4.0 is there are no content specific elements like header, footer, aside, article, section, etc. While in HTML 5.0, content specific elements are there like header, footer, aside, article, etc. HTML 4.0 does not support audio and video tag, while HTML 5.0 support audio and video tag. HTML 4.0 is based on SGML, means Standard Generalized Markup Language, and while HTML 5.0 is not based on SGML. HTML 4.0 works with all versions of browsers, while HTML 5.0 does not work with older version of browser. HTML 4.0 does not support date, date time, range, number, email, URL, color, week, range, etc. input type tag, while HTML 5.0 support all these input type tag. Next, HTML 4.0 does not support various form action, form method, form target, etc. attributes of input element, while HTML 5.0 support form action, form method, form target attributes of input element. In HTML 4.0, temporary storage is browser cache, while in HTML 5.0, its application cache, WebSQL database, is used for client-side storage. HTML 4.0 cannot handle inaccurate syntax, but HTML 5.0 is capable of handling inaccurate syntax. Thank you.